out there on the back porch, and I was looking for Ethel. She was out there maybe out in the corn or something. I couldn't tell. I was looking out there, and I just couldn't see. I was sipping back some whiskey, you see. I was getting back, and I was out there on the back porch. I'm chilling. Then all of a sudden, it started happening like this. I was heading downstairs, and I went downstairs, I said. Yeah, I went downstairs.
Yeah, I got a ear for you, mister.
And he said, well, listen. And I did. I listened. I gave him all the ear I had. And when he let out with the next story, telling me stuff like I didn't ever hear before, I couldn't even believe it. My eyes lit up and my eyebrows went up to the top of my forehead. Crept right up there underneath the edge of my hair, you see. And I didn't know what was going on. I looked at him with a big old wide eye grin and I just said, wow. He said, boy. He said,
boy,
I didn't know what was going on.
I was scared, man.
And he said, boy. Well, I didn't know how to reply. I wandered down the hall. And that's where the story began. See, I was down the hall. And you keep on in and started listening to what I was saying. Because I went back there on that back porch. I was kicking back some whiskey, sitting back in my chair, looking for Ethel in the corn. And then I heard that strange sound coming from the basement. It crept up on me like this. It's so cold here. Well, I didn't know what to do. I just went on down the stairs and I
saw myself sitting right there on my myself looking in the corner and I didn't know what to do.
Well, I crept up to him.
Well, I could just set me just set me right up. He slapped my knee and said, boy.
No, I didn't.
I didn't listen.
Because I was supposed to. You see, I was supposed to listen, I guess.
Well, I'm sorry about that. I came right there close and I said, what do you have to tell me today?
And he did.
Well, you got ear for me, boy. I said, I got ear for you, mister.
I got ear for you right here. I'm listening with all the ear I got. And he told me with all the mouth he got the story. That's so wild. You never believe it. My eyes were wide open and my eyebrows were up at the top of my forehead. They were creeping right up underneath the hair, see? About the only thing I could do was say, wow.
As I happened to say. Lots of things used to happen to me when I was younger. When I was a lot younger than I am today. Why, back when I was a young lad.
You know what lad is, don't you?
That's a little boy, like a small boy.
Anyway.
I had nothing. I had absolutely nothing. I didn't have a street to live on.
I didn't have
a bed to sleep on.
I didn't have
a car to get to town
with.
I didn't have nothing.
But then
I got older.
Well, I grew up a little bit and I got,
I'd say probably a couple more inches on me.
And I thought I was a tough one, boy. I thought I could just whip up on those little boys that were smaller than me, and a man was I a mean
little bad boy.
It happens that way.
Sometimes you come across these little things in life that remind you of when you were small. And it brings you back.